First and foremost, I want to say that IFMIS is a good system, but I think those who are administering the system are not being efficient in the way they are managing, especially issues of connectivity. Because a county like Uasin Gishu and a city like Eldoret, we don't expect to experience challenges of connectivity. You know, it's offline, sometimes it's on, it comes on at midnight. In a city that is connected with fiber optic, I mean, such issues of connectivity we should really experience in far-flung counties that are having challenges of connectivity. So I think what we want to ask those responsible is to make sure that in terms of connectivity, that IFMIS link should be very reliable so that we are able to you know, make payments on time. Part of the reasons why you see counties not being able to pay their suppliers on time is because of issues of connectivity with IFMIS. Sometimes you hear a supplier saying, county holds us a lot of money. It's not that we don't have the money. We have the money, but you are unable to pay because the system is always offline, is always down. So the time it takes to make one complete transaction, it takes a lot of time to the extent that the business person waits for so long until the profit margin is eroded by the waiting period. So we really want to encourage those who are responsible for IFMIS to make sure that reliability in terms of connectivity is accurate and reliable so that we are able to transact.
There's a location that they operate at midnight and then by 5 in the morning they are switched off. Should we really be paralyzed?
It sometimes really paralyzes our operations, and we also want to tell those who are responsible that can we be consistent? You know, we know the government time of public servants when they are supposed to be working is between 8 and 5. We expect them to be on between 7 and probably even 8 p.m. And I mean, why can this system be on 24 hours? After all, if it has an audit trail, what is the worry? So we want to encourage them that they should do proper administration of the system.
We need them to move. Now that the country is getting back together after the fresh presidential election, we need the Ministry of Treasury to fast-track the release of funds to the county so that these counties cannot serve a gridlock in terms of discharging their functions and mandate to the people. This is one of the ways we will ensure that the country gets back to its feet, realizing that we have been politicking for almost 1 year. Therefore, they should resolve this bureaucracy of integrated financial management and information system. And we want to tell CS Rotich and the Minister of Treasury to come out and ensure they explain to the various counties, so that as we continue also with healing process and reconciliation, the counties, their functions and mandate cannot be affected. So that we are aware some of these counties, they have challenges. We are aware that there could be challenges, but in as much as the law is bureaucratic, in as much as the IFMIS system is bureaucratic, but we want to tell the Treasury and the CS Rosie to come out clear on this matter and ensure our counties are up and running, so that we now as Kenyans focus on rebuilding this nation, on rebuilding our counties, on rebuilding our villages, rebuilding our roads. Especially in this region, we have so many roads that are now passable, but the governors do not have the necessary funds to run some of these core functions, especially development funds. We have some of these hospitals, they need drugs. We have so many issues that the governors want to address. And therefore, on this point, we want to urge the Ministry of Treasury, they should fast-track some of release of this one. And I think our Senate, before we went on recess, we did pass the allocations of funds across our 47 counties. But we want to urge the Treasury, because the Senate has already given you the necessary support, and we did pass the allocation of funds. Can you ensure that we get rid of these systematic and system problems that are there due to IFMIS? And then they should also sit with various stakeholders, the Senate, the Council of Governors, and Ministry of Treasury. There should be a meeting so that we iron some of these teething problems going forward and ensure we rebuild our counties. We don't impede the functions and mandate of our counties across the 47 counties. And I think when we get back up and running, the country will put behind their issues of elections, their issues of contested politics and what have you. But what we are calling upon is that let us resolve this matter once and for all. Ndio hili taifa letu liende mbele, na nafikiri waziri wa fedha na pia wizara ya fedha wahakikishe kuwa wamejaribu kushughulikia mambo ya masuala ya IFMIS ili kaunti zetu ziweze kufanya kazi.